the Kennen. Gives him a lot of team fight as well. But yeah, T1.
Wow.
Poppy jungle, playing with a TF and a team fighting top lane. It's a little bit all over the place. I can see how it's going to come together a little bit with the Yordle comp.
Gives him maybe a 3v3 on bot.
Carrier not going to be in range to help just yet. Word comes down. Owner going to take the first half of the Q and going to get the shield now as well. FBI is exhausted. FBI has to flash back to safety. The follow through could be there, and it's first blood. Owner grabs it, ignited, but survives out of the
turn. With closer, okay. So could potentially be a 4v4 if Faker wants to join.
And we're going to have Sunday take a battle with Kana, maybe try to get him away from teleporting, but big damage. Kana could nearly tower dive him. Tidal Wave comes in. There's going to be a fight in the bottom side. No knockups really to be had. Kimayushi drops a bit low as the Lulu ult comes across. The flash follow, but he heals back up with the red ulti. Closer still wants in. Flash comes in, and they will get the rest of the damage. Finally, one kill on the board
for Kana. And now you have this big window as T1 where you have TP advantage top. You have the Destiny. You have like so much of a window to make a play. And all you lost for was, okay, Kimayushi did die. So I think this is now T1's turn, but 100 Thieves once again being the aggressors.
Oh, misses the chain again. Owner just sidestepping it, but maybe find a pillar. Keep him on Kimayushi.
He's available on Faker Chase.
Flashless. Yeah, here it is. Gonna flash the bubble, and here comes Faker. Here comes Owner for the stun. And that's gonna be one easily. Kana looking for a bit more. Finds a second kill. A solo onto the Nami. Nowhere for the Trundle to go either. Closer has some stats for now. Ulti gonna land. That's gonna be a root on Abenaga as Owner shows up for kill number.
Massive lead now, but for 100 Thieves, come on. That's basics. Tracking TP timers. There. You had
going to Owner. Thank you very much for the leash.
Oh, Kana has flash ulti. Yep.
Finds a stun. Big damage and a close. He needs his ulti come off now, but it's already deletion. Who he is gone. The rest of the bot lane already dead. Closer limping away with the split of the health, but it's just everyone dying. Owner's on a killing spree. Faker spots it. Closer. Yeah, sorry, buddy. You are dying here as well. 4-0 on the fight, and T1 are slaughtering.
And overall, I feel like it's just been everything across the board for T1. Really nice early game pathing coming out from Owner. Nice early game plays. I love the draft overall. And the team fighting as well has been on point as Abenaga not going to get away.
Faker going to heal in for the gold card to get in the range. Abenaga going to go for the guesswork. Sorry, buddy. This time they found it out, and that's going to be him dropping. So mid lane tier 2 also going to drop. Thank you, second Rift Herald. 3 turrets to 0, 9 kills to 1, 1 dragon to nothing. Practically a perfect game against 100 Thieves.
Yeah, this is just an absolute blasting at this point. T1 got the early advantage on the bot
already,
side.
But T1 scouted the rest of this team by themselves, and here they are back at Worlds.
Ooh, Faker did not scout out this play coming out from 100 Thieves, though.
Good stun, good damage, flash, maybe to safety. Not closers here. Big shutdown of the Trundle.
So even we just watched EDG scout, of course, coming from that organization. Definitely historic with the players that they have been able to bring up.
It's also interesting because they're one of the few top teams.
Loses. You know, Benny, who's a mid lane sub, closer lost. Now against him, jungle. Ready to siege yet another turret. Nearly crushing that 10,000 gold difference. Someday, nearly another turret. He's dead to this. Ulti, big stun, big heal. Gore Drinker, not gonna be enough. Kana went for early Grievous Wounds that made the difference, and down goes Someday.
Man, I mean, he is just so fed. 2.5 items, didn't even need to use the stopwatch there. Solo kills Someday under the inhibitor tower. 21 minutes in, that inhibitor. They did challenge them in the finals this year. Did push him pretty hard. 100 Thieves trying to contest here.
Close
but too
he gets the Baron, but is it going to be much more? A clutch smite to be sure. However, it's still one kill picked up. Faker finds a tidal wave. Kana sidesteps and doesn't find his way in for a slicing maelstrom. So
does get it, but T1 definitely could have done a much better job preventing that.
You know, T1. I Owner here to make it even easier. Someday can barely tax some minions, despite the Baron buff, despite it being plus 1,000 gold for Red Bull Baron power play. It's been T1. Kana gonna take some damage, has to burn the Zonias. Ulti onto 3 is a big root, and that might be the team fight. FBI gotta cleanse and run away. Inhibitor still going to fall. Now, will they find a battle here? Owner.
I like 100 Thieves looking for that topside play. It goes back to what you were hitting on earlier, Azil, about trying to hit a chain and set something up. But I don't really think they should have the opportunity, but I look wrong.
Cannot get over the wall, so they're going to have a hard time joining Someday here. Wants to stun Owner. Decent damage. Stopwatch burn Faker here, but not a lot of damage out of him either. Owner going to get back to safety to the rubble of his turret.
As here comes Kennen.
And Kennen, yes, Someday has to mark it, but he can't find the stun. The flash is too soon. Kana plays it beautifully, kills off two, and Someday is going to be next. Gets a heal, it's not going to matter. And it's time for T1 to march into the 100 Thieves base.
Yeah, Kana coming out so big. 100 Thieves trying to find the pick, but T1 just keep pulling off such insane games. individually looking super good here today.
Kana is just playing out of his mind in this one on the cannon, destroying 100 Thieves. They're pushing in through top. They'll grab another inhibitor. Supers are already on the Nexus towers, but T1, they're gonna make it painful. They don't wanna end.
Nope, go shop one more time. Look, the respawns are coming in. They want the extra gold. Maybe they go for the dragon, so maybe they go for Baron in 1 minute's time. 100 Thieves, they lose it.
K versus Celsius gain this gold lead.
Decent damage on a carry. They find one for nothing. Kana gets a stun onto the two frontliners as it is going to be Trundle dropping. It's a 4v4 doable. Gumayushi, he gale forces forwards and just finds himself the kill as the FBI tried to open up but gets shut down instead. Who he going to drop? And Faker finds the kill onto Huhi. It's time to get away from this one. It's time for T1 to march straight down the mid lane.
You know, 100 Thieves did everything they did with so much confidence. I kept believing they could bring it back, but T1 are just too far ahead. They have the death timers. They're going to be able to just push into the base and look for the close.
Somehow a 2v4 defense has to happen as Carrier respawns inside the fountain. The son of Abadaga. Faker a little bit low. Owner in there as well. Doesn't quite find the kill, but Gumayushi going to find himself the turret. And now the Nexus is open. The Nexus will drop. And T1 in under 30 minutes take down their primary competition and are in control of second place so far in the group.
Well played, game.